For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And we say thank you again, everybody, and welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge. Moving along nicely, this is our fourth of the four quarterfinal round games to be played. Three teams have won. We have three of our final four ready to participate in the semifinals. We need one more team there. We're going to get that tonight as we have two new teams, each with two wins under their belt, ready to compete in this quarterfinal. Let's introduce you to those teams. First, we have the squad from Bishop Brady High School. With an enrollment of approximately 400 students, Bishop Brady located in New Hampshire's Merrimack County.
Hi, I'm Nick, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm James, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Zach, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Anupa, and I'm a junior.
With us for the program, the coach for the team, Eric Diamond. His alternates are Connor Houghton and Tom Arena, and they are the Green Giants from Bishop Brady High School. So there are the Green Giants. Now let's introduce you to their opponents for this quarterfinal round game. This is the team from St. Thomas Aquinas High School, enrolling some 676 students. St. Thomas located in New Hampshire's Stratford County.
Hi, I'm Matt and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Mike and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Tim and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Anna and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Charles Prince. His alternates are Allison Hyatt, Ben Willett, and John Hume, and they are the Saints from St. Thomas Aquinas High School. One last introduction, as we do each week at this time, to let you know who our judges have been for the season, and again tonight, Mary Riley Potter and Ann Belanger. All right, we're ready to go into round number one. This is our 10-point toss-up round. You know about the bonus round coming up, as well as the 60-second round, but these are 10-pointers for Bishop Brady and for St. Thomas Aquinas. What is the relationship of the alternate exterior angles of two parallel lines? James of Bishop Brady. St. Thomas, Mike.
They're equal.
They are congruent. Who wrote, "No man is an island entire of itself," Nick of Bishop Brady?
John Donne.
John Donne is correct. This Portsmouth, New Hampshire native and retired professional golfer had 27 LPGA Tour wins in her career. A Matt of St. Thomas.
Handa.
Good try, Bishop Brady. The golfer was Jane Blaylock. Identify the westernmost U.S. state that borders upon one of the Great Lakes. A Nick of Brady.
Minnesota.
Minnesota is correct. Insulin, a protein necessary for the proper metabolism of sugar, is produced in what organ of the body, Mike of St. Thomas?
Pancreas.
Pancreas is right. This American composer and lyricist wrote the scores for Sweeney Todd, Sunday in the Park with George, and Into the Woods. His name was Stephen Sondheim. Give the number 44 in Roman numerals. XLIV. This newspaper, founded in Portsmouth on October 7th, 1756 by printer Daniel Fowle, is still in print today. Tim of St. Thomas.
The Portsmouth Herald.
Bishop Brady. Zach.
Union Leader.
Well, good try on both parts, but it's called the New Hampshire Gazette. All right, here we go for 10 points. What kinds of electric current are represented by the abbreviations AC and DC? Zach of Brady.
Alternating currents and direct currents.
You got it for your 10 points. This Nashua, New Hampshire inventor and engineer is known as the father of video games. He had developed a video game console prototype, Brown Box, by 1968. In 1972, Brown Box became the Magnavox Odyssey, the world's first home video game console. Name that inventor. His name, Ralph Baer. Let's go with paper and pencil in front of you for 10 points. What is the product when the reciprocal of 3 over 8 is multiplied by the reciprocal of 1 over 8? We have Anupa Brady.
64 over 3.
That is correct for your 10 points. Which phenomenon first noticed in 1836 and named after a British astronomer? Nick of Brady.
Halley's Comet.
I can repeat it for St. Thomas. Which phenomenon first noticed in 1836 and named after a British astronomer is defined as brilliant spots of sunlight shining through valleys on the rim of the moon just after a total eclipse of the sun? Mike?
Sunspots.
And it's called Bailey's Beads after Francis Bailey. Now we want you to name the detective Sir Arthur Conan Doyle created, Mike of St. Thomas.
Sherlock Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes is correct. Although she is known for her novels set in the Great Plains like My Antonia and O Pioneers, Mike of St. Thomas. I can repeat it for Bishop Brady. Although she is known for her novels set in the Great Plains like My Antonia and O Pioneers, this novelist is buried in the old burying ground in Jaffrey Center, New Hampshire. James?
Louisa May Alcott.
Could try My Antonia, written by Willa Cather. Name the British poet whose best known work is To an Athlete Dying Young. Nick of Brady.
Lord Tennyson.
St. Thomas. Tim.
Percy Shelley.
It was A.E. Houseman. The Strait of Magellan separates the southern tip of Nick of Bishop Brady.
South America.
I can repeat for St. Thomas, but I won't, Matt.
Peru.
And I'll repeat the question. The Strait of Magellan separates the southern tip of South America from which group of islands whose name means land of fire? Tierra del Fuego is what we were looking for. We want you to name the Dutch scientist who discovered bacteria with a microscope, a Nick of Brady.
Leeuwenhoek.
That is correct for 10 points. Another math question before we end the round. Here we go for 10 points. If there are 1,000 votes and one of the two candidates gets 60% of them, by how many votes does he win? James of Brady.
200.
200 is correct. For 10 points, name the founder of modern science who once said that if there were no other evidence, the mere existence, James of Brady.
Albert Einstein.
I can repeat it for St. Thomas. Name the founder of modern science who once said that if there were no other evidence, the mere existence of the human thumb would convince him that God exists. Mike.
Darwin.
It was Isaac Newton. In 1990, the Philadelphia Zoological Society displayed a giant rodent to honor Benjamin Franklin's sense of humor because it looks a little like him. Identify this animal, the world's largest rodent. Tim.
Capybara.
Capybara is right. Chromosomes are strands of protein and DNA which help carry genetic material in the cells. Typically, how many pair of chromosomes are found in the human cell, James of Brady?
23.
23 is right. What is the official language of Iran? Nick of Brady.
Persian.
Persian is correct. Who was the Portuguese explorer who gave the Pacific Ocean its name because of its still waters? Mike of St. Thomas.
Magellan.
Magellan is right. Who mentioned his dog Checkers in his 1952 televised speech? Mike of St. Thomas.
President Nixon.
Richard Nixon is correct. For another 10-pointer, in which New York City borough would you find the neighborhood of Harlem? Mike of St. Thomas. Bishop Brady. Nick.
Manhattan.
Manhattan is correct. And there's the sound ending our round, and it warmed up nicely at the end of that round. Bishop Brady getting a little bit of a lead by a score of 90-50 after our first round of play. All right, we're going to take a timeout. Lori Warner is going to join us again this week. This week, she's been talking with the captains of the teams participating. Right now, she's talking with the captain from Bishop Brady High School.
Thank you, Jim. I have from Bishop Brady High School the captain, Nick Amadeo. Now, Nick, I had to write down all these things that you do. You're a senior from Hooksett.
Mm-hmm.
You play trumpet.
Yes.
You sing. You do robotics. You do Model UN. You do cross country. So sort of more like a renaissance kind of a guy.
Yes, I've been described thusly before. Really, it's just such a flurry of activity for me. I think it's...
So you fit in school and sleeping and eating in there as well?
Yes.
And
sometimes, or whenever I can.
Mm-hmm. And you also somehow managed to get into a lightsaber duel in a casino. I
did, actually. That was back when I was a freshman. I was competing at a national sort of trivia competition, and one of my teammates and I, we got into some sort of altercation. We also both happened to be Jedi, so and we were at the gambling night of that event, and we got into a fight. Luckily, we was just in the best spirit of friends, but if it was real, I guess you could say it would have been gambling with my life.
Not that he practiced that line or anything, no.
No,
speaking
not
of
at
practices,
all.
How many practices have you guys been through to try and get to this point in the competition?
Our practices are quite rigorous. We, we employ various methods to keep us in focus, many of which involve electricity, box springs,
and snacks.
Bamboo slivers, yes. There are various ways to keep us focused.
I'm kind of afraid now, and I think that perhaps we should get back to the game, Nick, because you have to go practice that with the teammates right now.
Yes.
All right, we'll turn things back over to you, Jim, and the best of luck.
Thank you.
All right, Laurie, thank you very much, I think. And thanks to Nick for being captain of this Bishop Brady team. Right now, they lead 90-50 after round number one. We head into our second round, which is our bonus round. We'll be giving the 10-point toss-up questions out like we did before. Team that gets the answer correct will have a chance at bonus points. So good luck, Brady and St. Thomas. Here we go. During the American Revolution, what was a Tory? Mike of St. Thomas.
Someone who supported the crown.
That is correct. A British supporter is what we're looking for, and you are right. So over to St. Thomas we go. Matt, you're the team captain. You'll speak for each of them, but right now let's choose a category from Trip the Light Fantastic. Two heads are better than one. A pirate's life for me. Two heads are better than one. And we want you to identify the following related to characters with more than one head. This Roman god of gates, doors, and beginnings and endings has one head facing forward and one head facing backwards.
Janus.
Correct. This character in Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy has two heads and three arms.
Pass.
That is Beeblebrox. And three-headed dog in Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone.
Fluffy.
Is right. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Here we go for 10 points. This battle of the War of 1812 was fought after the Treaty of Ghent was signed. James of Brady.
The Battle of New Orleans.
That is correct for the 10 points. So over to Brady we go, where Nick is the captain. He'll be speaking for them and choosing a category from Trip the Light Fantastic, a Pirate's Life for Me, or A Diamond is Forever.
Pirates.
Trip the Light Fantastic.
A Pirate's Life for Me.
A Pirate's Life for Me. Identify the following relating to pirates. According to legend, this pirate, whose real name was Edward Teach, left buried treasure on Lunging Island in the Isle of Shoals.
Blackbeard.
Correct. The flag flown by pirate ships is known by this name.
The Jolly Roger.
Correct. This pirate helped General Andrew Jackson defend New Orleans against the British in 1815.
Jacques Ribon.
There was Jean Lafitte. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Let's go for another 10-pointer. Which U.S. state was named for a man who was a European king from 1643 to 1715? Zach of Brady.
Louisiana.
Louisiana is correct. So back over to the Green Giants we go for Trip the Light Fantastic. A Diamond is Forever. Kilroy was here.
A Diamond is Forever.
A Diamond is Forever for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following related to diamonds. Graphite and diamonds are allotropes of this element.
Carbon.
Correct. This famous blue diamond can be seen at the Smithsonian Natural History Museum. Correct. Term for a diamond mined in a war zone and sold to finance.
Blood diamond.
That is correct. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. Well done. 10 points. Which three words did Newton Minow, chairman of the Federal Communications Commission, use to describe the state of television programming in 1961? The three words were a vast wasteland. Along which river is the United States Military Academy located at West Point? Mike of St. Thomas.
Hudson River.
Hudson River is correct. So back over to St. Thomas we go. We still have Trip the Light Fantastic. We have Kilroy was here, and we have two states.
Two states.
Two states it will be. We want you to identify the word formed from the postal abbreviations of each of the following sets of states. South Carolina and Arkansas.
SCAR.
Correct. Colorado and Alabama.
Cole.
Correct. Georgia and Indiana.
Gain.
That's simple enough for 15 points on the bonus. Let's go with another 10-pointer. What is the largest prime factor of 57? Anupa, Bishop Brady.
19.
19 is correct for your 10 points. So back over to the Green Giants we go. For Trip the Light, Fantastic, Kilroy Was Here or Capital Neighbors?
Capital Neighbors.
Let's go with Capital Neighbors. We want you to identify the capital of the following countries. Canada.
Ottawa.
Correct. Haiti.
Port-au-Prince.
Correct. Mexico.
Mexico City.
15 more points for Brady on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our game. A high-scoring second round. Bishop Brady maintaining the lead at the halfway mark, though, by a score of 160 to 95. We have our 60-second round right around the corner, but right now, Lori Warner joins us. She's talking with the captain from St. Thomas Aquinas High School.
Thank you, Jim. We've got our captain from St. Thomas Aquinas, Matt Devine. Now, Matt, you live over in Exeter.
Yep.
And you are a senior this year.
Correct.
What are you doing after school?
Well, I'm big into outdoor activities. I like to hike, camp, and ski. I'm on, like, the ski race team, so I do that during the winter. And then I go up on the weekends with my friends and my dad. So.
Slalom or giant slalom?
Both, actually.
Nice. So you go fast and out of control.
Yeah, we try.
Excellent. Now, I also read that you went skiing out in Colorado.
Yeah, that's true. My first trip was back when I was in the fifth grade. That was a really fun experience. So, and we've been going back infrequently ever since. But
I always find like the first couple of days trying to ski in the powder is like the human snowball imitation.
Yeah.
skiing out here is like snow and ice and rocks. Yeah. I'm great on that, but yeah. The snow is kind of challenging. But now, what do you do with the team to get ready for this?
At the practices, we mainly listen and watch the matches, usually online on a projector, and try and get a sense for the game. Mm-hmm. When we're here, we usually don't do much. We kind of sit around, listen to some music, try and relax before the game. So
yeah, and the big commute from Dover to Durham.
Yeah,
so it's got to take
trip.
All 15 minutes, so not a lot of practice time there. All right, and any strategies that you're going to employ for today?
Buzzing when you know it. You don't really have much of a strategy, so
just
going to go
at
it. Yeah.
Now, what do you find to be the most challenging about being here?
It's probably getting used to the nerves at first. Once you're in there, it doesn't get too bad, but before.
Yeah, and the cameras and the lights and the retina burns and all that good stuff. Well, it's time for us to get back in the studio, speaking of that, so the best of luck.
All right,
and
you.
We are back over to you, Jim.
Again, Lauren, thank you very much. And to Matt and his team from St. Thomas Aquinas, halfway through this game, they look to come from behind, beginning right here in this 60-second round. We'll be asking each of the teams 10 questions in 1 minute. We'll give them 10 points for every correct answer. Bonus them 10 should they get them all right in under that minute of time. So, St. Thomas, choose from these categories. State of Affairs, Places to Eat, Take Me to Your Leader. State of Affairs, Places to Eat, Take Me to Your Leader.
Take Me to Your Leader.
All right, Take Me to Your Leader. And Matt, you're the team captain. I take your answer for the team. We want you to identify the countries associated with these women leaders. Start the clock. Prime Minister Golda Meir.
Israel.
Correct. Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher.
England.
Correct. Prime Minister Indira Gandhi.
India.
Correct. Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto.
Iran.
Pakistan. Prime Minister Angela Merkel.
Germany.
Correct. President Corazon Aquino.
Pass.
Queen Beatrix.
France.
It's the Netherlands. Prime Minister Helen Clark.
Ireland.
New Zealand. President Mary Robinson.
Australia.
Is Ireland and Queen Nefertiti.
Egypt.
Correct. Judges, 5 out of 10 on their 60-second round of Take Me to Your Leader. So 50 points onto the scoreboard. And we'll go over to Bishop Brady for State of Affairs or Places to Eat.
State of Affairs. Are you sure? Please. All right. State of Affairs, please.
Let's go with State of Affairs. And all we want you to do right here is identify the capitals of the following states. Start the clock. Alabama.
Montgomery.
Correct. Delaware.
Wilmington.
It's Dover. Oregon.
Salem.
Correct. Washington.
Olympia.
Correct. South Dakota.
Pierre.
Correct. Nevada.
Carson City.
Correct. New Jersey.
Trenton.
Correct. Ohio.
Columbus.
Correct. Louisiana.
Baton Rouge.
Correct. Kansas?
Topeka.
And that's 9 out of 10 on their 62nd round under the state of affairs. So that brings us to the end of round 3. Bishop Brady maintains the lead, 250 to 145. No more talking the rest of the way, teams. 10-point toss-ups, here we go. In which major league sport can a player not return to the game after having a substitute take his place? Mike of St. Thomas.
Soccer.
Nick?
Baseball.
Baseball is correct. The Aswan Dam crosses the Nile River. Nick of Bishop Brady.
Egypt.
In what country? Egypt is correct. Identify the American inventor of the first commercially successful steamboat. James of Bishop Brady.
Robert Fulton.
Robert Fulton is right. The Panama Canal opened in the same year that what war began? Nick of Bishop Brady.
World War I.
That is correct. If the area, again, you may want to have the paper and pencil if you think you might need it. If the area of a circle is 9 pi square units, what is its exact circumference? Anupa of Brady.
6 pi.
6 pi units is correct. How many large islands make up Japan? Nick of Bishop Brady.
3.
St. Thomas. Mike.
4.
4 is correct. Teddy Roosevelt helped lead the American troops up San Juan Hill, and then Zach of Bishop Brady.
Rough Riders.
I can repeat it for St. Thomas. Teddy Roosevelt helped lead the American troops up San Juan Hill, and then he was rewarded with what political office? Tim.
President.
It is Vice President from where he was there. His Committee on Public Safety started the Reign of Terror in 1793. Tim of St. Thomas.
Robespierre.
Robespierre is correct. The original inhabitants of Hawaii are thought to have come from Tahiti or Samoa. What is the name for this, Nick of Bishop Brady?
Polynesia.
What is the name of the judges? Will you take that, Polynesia? Yes, we'll take it. What's the name for this race up? I'm sorry, then I'm going to have to throw the question away because I just gave the answer. Let's continue. The Peace of Westphalia brought independence to this country. Zach Brady.
India.
St. Thomas. Tim.
France.
It is the Netherlands. Which weapon enabled the English under Edward III and his son, James of Bishop Brady?
The longbow.
The longbow, his son, the Black Prince, to defeat a much larger French army. For another 10 points, what subclass of flowering plants has netted leaf veins and flower parts in 4s or 5s? The subclass is called dicots. Now for 10 points, near which cape and in which state was the Astronaut Hall of Fame dedicated in 1990 in the city of Titusville? I'm sorry, Nick of Brady.
Cape Canaveral, Florida.
That is correct, Cape Canaveral, Florida. All right, we have about 2 minutes to go in our game. What is another name for our Matt of St. Thomas?
I don't know.
I can repeat for Bishop Brady. What is another name for Holland? Zach.
The Netherlands.
Netherlands is correct. Now for 10 points, what leader marched out of Russia with 10,000 men? Nick of Bishop Brady.
Napoleon Bonaparte.
He did that months after marching in with 442,000 men. What is the sum of the degree measures of 2 complementary angles? We have Matt of St. Thomas Aquinas.
90.
90 degrees is correct. Identify the mythological one-eyed giant named Cyclops, Mike of St. Thomas Aquinas.
Polyphemus.
Polyphemus is correct for your 10 points. The annual Iditarod sled dog race, Mike of St. Thomas.
Alaska.
I can repeat it for Bishop Brady. The annual Iditarod sled dog race ends in this city, Nick.
Nome.
Nome is correct, about a minute to go. Which 3-word French phrase containing the word belle designates the period between the end of the Franco-Prussian War in 1871 and the outbreak of World War I in 1914? It's called la belle époque. If something is ferrous, which metal does it contain? We have James of Bishop Brady.
Iron.
Iron is correct for the 10 points. This man opened one of the first five and dime stores in Utica, New York in 1878 and in 1913. He built what was then, at 57 stories, the world's tallest building. Matt of St. Thomas.
Rockefeller.
Bishop Brady. Zach.
Cornelius Vanderbilt.
It was F.W. Woolworth. All right, we go with another 10-point toss-up question. Oh, no, we don't. There's the sound ending our round, and it will be Bishop Brady advancing on into our semifinals. A good win tonight over St. Thomas Aquinas, a final score of 360 to 185. So congratulations to Bishop Brady for entering our semifinals, and for St. Thomas Aquinas for two impressive wins earlier in the season for a good game here tonight. Well, we're down to our final four. We have two semifinal round games coming right up. The first one will take place 1 week from tonight as Conval, Catoosa Valley Regional High School, takes on Portsmouth Christian Academy of Dover. That's our first semifinal coming up next week. Hope you'll be here. See you then. Good night, everybody.